إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, أخرج الإمام مسلم في صحيحه من حديث عياض ابن حمار المجاشعي رضي الله عنه. الإمام مسلم رحمه الله compiled a hadith, the narrator of which is a companion رضي الله عنه, عياض ابن حمار المجاشعي. الانفي حديث, but in this hadith the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ نَظَرَ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ فَمَقَتَهُمْ عَرَبَهُمْ وَعَجَمَهُمْ إِلَّا بَقَايَا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ نَظَرَ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ فَمَقَتَهُمْ عَرَبَهُمْ وَعَجَمَهُمْ إِلَّا بَقَايَا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looked towards the people in earth and he showed disgust, or he disliked them. Arabs and non-Arabs, except some remainders or leftovers from the people of the book. How do you understand that statement? This statement, brothers and sisters in Islam, explains the conditions or the condition of the people in earth right before the prophethood of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looked upon the people in earth, the overwhelming majority of them are mushriks. They associate some other deities, idols, objects in worship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's go through the Arabs. What is the condition of the Arabs at the time? We know that the Arabs for a long time they sticked to the millah of Ibrahim and his son Ismail alayhi salam. They used to worship one ilah, one God, until a man whose name is Amr ibn Luhay al-Khuza'i went to the greater Syria, Isham, And he saw them there worshipping idols. He liked it. He brought idols with him back to Mecca. And from that time on, the Arabs went astray from the way of Ibrahim and his son Ismail. And in this regard, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, والحديث في البخاري من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه رأيت عمرو بن لحي الخزاعي يجر قصبه في النار. I saw عمرو بن لحي الخزاعي dragging his intestines, his inside in the hellfire. فإنه كان أول من سيب السوائب. He was the first person who introduced shirk to the Arabs. But not all of the Arabs followed the way of mushriks. Actually, a lot of them stick to the millah of Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son Ismail, such as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, before his prophethood, we know he never prostrated to an idol. He used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to the millah of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Also, another companion, he was a companion, but he died before the prophethood of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the father of Sa'id ibn Zayd ibn Amr ibn Nufayl. Zayd ibn Amr ibn Nufayl used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to the millah of Ibrahim. Before the prophethood of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Asma radiyallahu anha narrates a hadith, wal hadith fi sahih al-Bukhari, that she said, Ra'aytu Zayd ibn Amr ibn Nufayl. I saw Zayd ibn Amr ibn Nufayl placing his back to the Kaaba, and he's talking to the mushriks. Ya ma'ashara Quraysh, O Quraysh, wallahi, by Allah, ما أصبح منكم أحد على ملة إبراهيم غيري. And he's so proud of it. I'm the only one around here who worships Allah according to the millah of Ibrahim. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال عن هذا الرجل, he said about him, يبعث يوم القيامة أمة واحدة. He will be resurrected in the day of resurrection as an ummah by himself. And his son is one of the 10 who were given glad tidings of Jannah. Sa'id ibn Zayd ibn Amr ibn Nufayl. This is the Arabs. طيب, what about the people of the book? We know that there is a period of 600 years between the ascending of Prophet Isa alayhi salam to the heavens and the prophethood of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. What happened? The author of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma, and the author is authentic, wa huwa fi sunan al-Nasa'i. After Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, Prophet Isa alayhi salam was raised to Allah, he said the people of the book divided into three groups. One group said, كان الله فينا ثم صعد إلى السماء. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came down to earth, took a form of a human being, and then he raised to the heavens. And those are called al-Ya'qubiyya, the Jacobites, whatever word you want to use. The other, they said, كان ابن الله فينا, the son of Allah was amongst us, and then Allah placed him in the cross for our sins, and then he rose from the dead after 3 days. That's sect number two, group number two. As for the third group, people who believed, لا إله إلا الله عيسى رسول الله. They understood, they comprehended the true message of Tawheed that Prophet Isa alayhi salam came to deliver to the children of Israel. And they said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lifted him and he will come down to earth. Exactly the way that Muslims believe. Now, the first two groups collaborated, worked together against that group. And they persecuted them. They killed them. And anyone who would disclose his tawheed, he would be persecuted and crucified and killed. Only few amongst them were left on tawheed. And this is where the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam refers to. Allah looked into or towards the people in earth and he disliked them. He hated them for their shirk, except some left over from the people of the book. In the time I have, I want to share with you a story of someone who belongs to the Ajam. Someone who is not from the people of the book. He's not Israelite. He's not a Jew or a Christian. Nor he's an Arab. And he was hated by Allah. He was disliked by Allah. And how he embarked on a journey in order to gain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That companion, brothers and sisters in Islam, his name is Salman al-Farisi, radiyallahu anhu. Salman the Persian. You see, he's not Arab. He's from Persia. He was born in a place called Asfahan, that we know now by Iran. And by the way, his story is best told by him. Regardless of what I do today, if you really want to enjoy that story, read it from his tongue. Well, يعني القصة is authentic. في مسند الإمام معجم الطبراني ومسند البزار and others. Authentic chain of narration. He says this. I was born in a place called Asfahan, in a village called G. My father used to be the Dahqan, like the mayor of the town. And he used to love me so much. And he used to love me so much that he would treat me like a jariya, like a little girl. And he would not let me go out. وَكُنَّا نَعْبُدُ النَّارِ Magian or Magian, the people who worship the fire. And we used to worship the fire. Al-Majusiyya hadi, yani they believe in that there are two forces in earth, good force and bad force, and they are fighting one another. But they worship idols. And the idol is the fire. And subhanAllah, Salman was so devoted to the worship of the fire, that he was elevated to become the guardian of the fire. And he was so sincere about it that he was elevated to become the guardian of the fire. The guardian of the fire is someone who makes sure that this fire does not go out. It's always burning. He said one day, my father, who had a real estate somewhere, got busy with the affairs of the village. And he had some business to take care of. He could not go. So he decided to send me. As I'm walking to the location where I'm supposed to go, I heard mumbling inside a Christian church. The psalms, Taranim. I became so curious. I got in. And I asked, who are you? They said, we are Christians. And I asked them where this religion originated. They said, in the greater Syria, Isham. And he liked it. He actually spent there the rest of the day until the sun sets. Until the sun set. And he did not even go to take care of his father's business. And then he returned to his father at the end of the day after he made a covenant with the Christians in that church that please, when there is a caravan that will go to the place where the religion originated, which is the greater Syria or Sham, please send the messenger to me because I want to go there. He went back home and he shared his experience with his father. My father, I was in that place and I loved it and it's a good religion. His father became so upset and he vowed that you're not going to go out of the house anymore. And he shackled him. The Christians fulfilled their promise. There was a caravan that is about to travel to Sham. And they sent for him. He was able somehow to release himself. And he got on that journey to the greater Syria. Once we say the greater Syria, we mean Sham, always Sham, Palestine, Jordan, Lebanon, and the Syria. That's Sham. That's why we say the greater Syria. Because it used to be one block, Sham. He arrived there, he got into a church, and he asked, who is the leader here? قالوا الأسقف, this bishop. He went to him and he said, I will serve you, in return, teach me your deen. Teach me your religion. He said, fine. Salman says, وكان رجل سوء. He used to be an evil man. كان يأمر الناس بالصدقة. He used to ask people to give sadaqah and he used to confiscate it. Take it away. He would not disperse it to the poor and the needy. To the extent that he actually collected 7 jars of gold and silver. And he hid them underneath the ground somewhere that Salman spotted. Once he died, the congregation came to bury him. Salman felt that he should share the information with them. He said, this man used to steal your money and the money in that place. Another person took over the church. Another leader. Salman radiallahu anh says, and I have not seen someone more trustworthy and honest and devoted to the worship of Allah than this man. He used to pray at night, give sadaqah. He renounced the dunya. When this man is about to die, Salman became concerned. He asked him, by Allah, I came all the way from Bergia, Asfahan. And I had a bad experience already with a previous teacher. And I have experienced you. You're a good person. And I'm afraid after your death, I may end up falling into the hands of some other corrupt teacher. Can you recommend for me a name of another teacher that I could join? Here's the statement that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam meant in the hadith that I began my khutbah with. Accept few from the people of the book. He said this, Wallahi, by Allah, I do not know a whole lot of people in the face of this earth who worship Allah the way that we are, the way that I worship Allah. Accept a man in a place called Al-Musil. Ya Allah, Al-Musil hadi fi Al-Iraq. Look, Sayyidina Salman, his title, by the way, the seeker of the truth. A lot of Muslims, they come out of ignorance. Yani, I say this with respect. And as soon as they reach some jama'ah or some group, they stick to the jama'ah and say, okay, this is the truth. Khalas, this is the jama'ah that got me out of darkness, so this is the truth. La ya akhi. Undur ila Salman. Ibhath an al-haqiqa. Ibhath an al-manhaj. Ibhath an al-haq. Look for the truth. Don't stop. Salman immediately went to Mosul in Iraq. Subhanallah, the same exact thing almost happened. After he spent some time with that teacher, he's about to die. He told him the same thing. Listen, you got to tell me another person that I could join. Don't leave me like that. He made the same statement almost. By Allah, there is not too many people like us in the face of this earth now. And again, this is the statement that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam meant. But I know a man in a place called Nasibin. Visualize the map now. He came to Palestine, back to Iraq. Nasibin هذه in northern Syria, if I'm not mistaken, somewhere there. Back. He went there again. The same exact thing happened. After he spent some time with this teacher, he's about to die. And he told him, please, tell me another person that I can go and learn from. He repeated the same exact statement. He said, by Allah, I do not know a lot of many people like us, except a man in a place called Amuriya. Amuriya هذه in Turkey. You see the truth, brothers? Truth. Don't stop. Salman traveled right away to Amuriya. But over there he did something different. He started working. And he had some savings that was materialized in some sheep and some cow. When this person was about to die, he asked him the same exact question. Please recommend for me another person I could join. Listen to this carefully. He said, by Allah, I do not know in the face of this earth someone who is devoted to the oneness of Allah and to the true religion of Prophet Isa alayhi salam to tell you about. But listen, this is the time of the coming of a messenger from the line of Ismail, the son of Ibrahim. He will migrate from his hometown to a city that is between two mountains, volcanic mountains. That Nakhlin has a lot of palm trees. لا يأكل الصدقة. If you give him sadaqah, he will not accept it. ويقبل الهدية. If you give him a present, a gift, he will accept it. وبين كتفيه خاتم النبوة. And between his two shoulders is the stamp of prophethood. هذا المعنى موجود في القرآن يا إخوة. This is in the Quran. Look. الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمي الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل. Allah is praising those who follow the messenger, the illiterate prophet, that they find his description written in their Torah and in their Injil. And this is the description right here. One of them knows about it. Sayyidina Salman, immediately, he found a caravan going towards Mecca or towards the Arabia. Look at this now. He told them, listen, my savings, some cows and some sheep. take it and take me to that prophet. Ya Allah. Giving up his savings. Subhanallah, the people betrayed him. They took his cows and his sheep away and they sold him in slavery. Look at the journey. Look at the journey. Look at the journey to Islam. Islam, the religion that we inherited. Just like that. Easy. This is someone who was fleeing from the disgust and the hate of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who establish the oneness of Allah in earth. But subhanallah, they sold him in a place called Wadi al-Qura, which is closer to Medina than to Sham, the greater Syria. And when he was sold to a Jewish person there, he saw that little town has a lot of palm trees. He felt good. He said, maybe that's the place. Maybe Allah brought me here. But it was not the place. The place is Yathrib, Medina. Brothers and sisters in Islam, his owner had a relative from the tribe that used to live in Medina, the Jewish tribe that used to live in Medina called Bani Qurayza. So he came to visit his cousin. Look at the work of Allah now. You see, all you have to do, just you try. You strive and Allah will take you to the path. وَمَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهِ مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهِ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهِ. Allah will give you the support. He came to visit his cousin. And he looked at Salman, the man from Bani Qurayza. He looked at Salman and he liked him. Devoted worker, very polite. And he asked his cousin to sell him to himself. And he took him to Medina as a slave. He said, as soon as I saw that city, because of the description that I was given by my last teacher, I became the happiest person in the face of this earth, because I learned then that this is the place where the messenger whom I want to follow and adhere to his teachings will migrate to. Let's find out what happened to Salman. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. سلمان stayed with his owner in Bani Qurayza in Medina, serving him. And it was the time when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated from Mecca to Medina. He describes his condition, that he was in the top of a palm tree fixing something there, when one of the people of Bani Qurayza came to visit his master and they had this conversation. The person said, لعن الله بني so and so. He means the Ansar, الأوس والخزرج. May Allah curse الأوس and الخزرج. There is a man who came to them from Mecca. They are making a big celebration for him and they are saying that he is a prophet. Salman describes his condition by saying, as if a chill went through my spine, that I shaked out of joy that I'm about to fall into the ground. He could not control himself. He finally got to the truth. He finally found the man. And he went down asking his master so many questions. Where is he? How is he? How does he look like? And his master, owner, hit him in his chest and say, go about your business. Don't ask questions. Salman still remembered and called the signs by which he would know this messenger is true or not. You see, you got to verify. Don't just join any jama'ah. Join jama'at al-Muslimin, the jama'ah of the Muslims, and verify that they follow the Quran and the practice of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He collected some dates and he went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in a masjid called Qiba. And he found his companions sitting and surrounding him. And he told him, I know that you're poor and your friends are poor and I brought you a sadaqah. Please take it from me. He took it from him and he did not eat of it. And he gave it to his companions and he told them, eat. Salman, between him and himself, he said, هذه واحدة. This is one. Not yet. Don't be deceived. The second time, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in his masjid, surrounded by his companions. He brought some dates. And he said that, I noticed the first time that you did not eat the sadaqah. And I brought to you a gift, a hadiyah. Please take it from me. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took it from him and he ate of it and he given the rest to his companions. He said, this is two. The third time, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in Baqi' al-Gharqad, the cemetery of the Muslims in Medina, burying one of the Muslims. And after the burial, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting with his companions and he was wearing something on his shoulder, that covering his shoulder. Sayyidina Salman radiallahu anh came over looking for that stamp of prophethood. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam noticed him. He uncovered his shoulder and he told him, عن هذا تبحث. Are you looking for this one? Salman, broken tears, he found Islam. He went down in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, crying and weeping and saying, Alhamdulillah, I found the truth. It was a difficult journey, very long journey, traveling, searching for the truth, trying to find it. And he finally did find it. Salman was the happiest person, brothers and sisters in Islam. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam was so amazed because of his reaction that he told him, what is wrong with you? Why are you doing this? He told him his story. The story that I just shared with you. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so impressed by his story that he told them, I want you to narrate that story by yourself to your companions, to my companions. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the story of one person who was looking for having what you have. What you have. Are you happy with what you have? Are you grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what you have? Are you grateful to Allah for Islam? If you are grateful to Allah, I'll give you a little test tonight, and I'm not being personal. Don't celebrate the new year, because that is not our year. Stay at home with your family. Don't look like the non-Muslims. If you're grateful for what you have, pray your 5 daily prayers. Allah said, you can do it. Allah said, I will not burden someone more than what he can bear. The fact that Allah told you that pray 5 times, that means you're able to. Don't be afraid. Don't be weak. Have a strong will. If you're really grateful to Allah for what you have, learn the sunnah of the Prophet. Learn the sunnah. And follow the ummah at large. Don't follow a jama'ah or a group. إن سألوك عن شيخك فقل شيخي رسول الله. If they ask you who is your sheikh, tell them my sheikh is the messenger of Allah. وإن سألوك عن دينك فقل ديني الإسلام. And if they ask you about your deen, say my deen is Islam. The Muslims are so divided, brothers and sisters in Islam at this time, because of the unawareness of that beautiful, pure religion. If you're really grateful to Allah for Islam, follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If you are grateful to Allah for your Islam, practice it in real life. Don't backbite about your brother. Don't gossip. If somebody comes and tells you something bad about your brother, verify it. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنْ جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَإٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا أَنْ تُصِيبُوا قَوْمًا بِجَهَالَةٍ. If you're grateful to Allah for Islam, help the ummah. Help the community. Don't be a destructive force. Be a constructive force. Join hands with the imam of the masjid, with the rest of the congregation. Don't try to create your little world inside the jama'ah. It's not good. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that one imam, one jama'ah. Not jama'at inside the same congregation. Not good. I say this for the sake of Allah, fearing nobody. And this is what I believe in. And I will continue believing in bi-idhnillah, by the lead and the help and support of Allah. And I will not compromise it for a second. I will not. هذا ما أدين الله به. If you're grateful to Allah for Islam, please take care of your family. Teach them that religion. I'm so delighted to see a lot of my brothers bringing their children to the masjid. Even so, they may feel the discomfort. But teach your children Islam. Sit with them tonight. Talk to them about Allah. Talk to them about the deen. If you're grateful to Allah for Islam, give da'wah to the non-Muslims. But not words. Actions. If you're at work, don't be afraid. Pray. Don't fear your boss. He's not going to fire you. He's not going to beat you up. Pray. Like you take 5 minutes for a cigarette break sometimes. Take 5 minutes for a salah break. Talk to them about Islam kindly. Give Islam to the non-Muslims. Show your gratefulness to Allah, brothers and sisters in Islam, for the religion that you have. In conclusion, Salman was a slave. He was freed by the help and the support of the ummah. And here is Salman, the burgeon الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم says about him, سلمان منا آل البيت. He's one of my family members. سلمان. And as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spared him after he missed on the battle of Badr and the battle of Uhud because of slavery to hold the ummah in the battle of the trench. When 10,000 came marching to wipe Islam and Muslims from the face of the earth. إِذْ جَاءُوكُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِكُمْ وَمِنْ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ وَإِذْ زَاغَتِ الْأَبْصَارِ وبلغت القلوب الحناجر وتظنون بالله الظنون. سلمان introduced a solution to the whole ummah. يا رسول الله, let's dig a trench around Medina so that they will not cross to us. Regardless of your color, regardless of your tongue, regardless of your race, if you have the right tawheed and you're following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are a valuable member of this community.